Now we will have a look into the third topic, that is test automation benefits. So it is a straightforward topic. Let's see what all things are there. So it is K1. If you get a question, it will be direct from this topic. Identify benefits and risk of test automation. So first we will see the benefits, and after that we will see the risk associated with test automation process. So there are few benefits which are listed down here. The four are listed down here. Reduction in repetitive manual work. So whatever manual work we do, and that repetition is reduced. Okay, reduction in repetitive manual work. Greater consistency and repeatability. So since we have the tool now, we can repeat it again and again, and then we also achieve the consistency with that. More objective assessment. Now with the tool, we can more objectively assess the result. Easier access to the information. So whatever information we need, the tool will generate and give it to us. So we have easier access to the information. Let's go through these points one by one. First point is reduction in repetitive manual work. How? We do regression testing, especially in case of agile project. This regression testing is very beneficial. So we have different releases planned, and in each release what we do is testing is part of that particular release. So we have to test here. Same test cases along with additional test cases we have to test here. Now developer has to only develop the new test cases, or he has to fix the bug. But if we don't automate, we have to test the previous activity, previous features as well as the new features. So our task will increase. Whereas if we automate these things, then we also have to only test the new things. Similarly, when you go to the third sprint, you have to test the features of sprint 1, sprint 2, as well as the feature of sprint 3. That means as the sprint increases, the testing task also increases. The number of test cases will increase. And same test cases you have to run in each sprint. So therefore, the tools will help in regression testing. So reduction in repetitive manual work. So this way we can avoid this, by using the tool, we can avoid the repetitive work. Re-entering same data. So if there is a spreadsheet, after the execution, what we need to do? We have to mention that something is passed, something is failed, something like that. So this is a repetitive data. Using a tool, we can directly fill all these things. So that way, we are also reducing the repetitive manual activities. And then, checking the code against the coding standard. This is also a very lengthy process. If you have a code and then if someone has to go through it one by one, it's difficult and they may miss also. But by using a tool such as QAC, Quality Assessment Control Tool, if we use such tool, using that tool, what we can do is we can do the comparison between the coding standards very easily. So this is a repetitive task. Every time you release the software, you have to do this coding standard analysis. So if you use a tool, you can reduce this repetitive activities. Moving further, the second one is greater consistency and repeatability. So this is quite obvious. Time for executing the test case will remain the same. Since you have a tool, every time it will run that particular test case, the time is same. Whereas with human being, we cannot say that with the same time we can get the data every time, right? So that is one thing. Report generated by the tool will have the same format. So whatever format we set, we will get the data in the same format. Then we will have the flexibility to change the execution order. So whichever way we want to execute, this is the tool, whatever way we will keep the data, the same way it will execute. And then comparison of measured data and expected data will be accurate every time. So whatever data we feed, the measured data is compared against the expected data, and based on whether they are same or they are not same, the result will be generated. And it is also consistent and accurate every time. So greater consistency and repeatability we can achieve. Another example is regression test. So again and again we can run our test cases. Third one, more objective assessment we can do. So if we have the tool, we can generate different type of data which can help us to do an objective assessment like requirement coverage. So we know that coverage is nothing but how many test cases we have tested divided by the total number of test cases, and if you multiply it with 100, you will get it in percentage. We can do these things manually, but if you have a tool, you can just set some attributes and then you will see that, okay, how many requirements are linked, how many test cases are executed, how many test cases are passed, failed. All these data we can get with just a click away. So just by clicking, we will get all this data. So more objective assessment can be done in a short span of time. Next one is easier access to information about testing. So same point. So you have a tool and then getting coverage data is very easy if you have tool. Using this data, we can plot different statistics and graphs. So whatever way we want the data to be visible, to be shown, that way we can configure it and then we will get the data in that form. So how many test cases are passed, how many, like it's the MISRA guideline, it's for the coding standard. So how many requirements or how many line of code are not compliant, like that. All these data, different data we can get in different format. So this was the fourth point. And now let's summarize all the points. So we saw the potential benefits. One is reduction in the repetitive manual work, greater consistency and repeatability, more objective assessment, easier access to information. These are the four points or four benefits of the test automation. As per ISTQB, we can have some more benefits also. Obviously. Now let's have a look into this question. Which of the following benefits are most likely to be achieved by using a test tool? So if we are using a test tool or test automation tool, I mean to say, then what are the benefits which we are going to achieve from it? Easy to assess information about test and testing. Yes. Reduced maintenance of testware, this we have to see. So one is the answer, first of all. So that is with C and D. So A and B are not our answer. So C and D only we have to look. That means four and third. Third is easy and cheap to implement. Greater consistency of test. Yes, we achieve the consistency. We get easy access to the information. So first and four are the answer. That means option C is the answer over here. We have to mark C as our correct answer. Let's see another question. Which of the following are potential benefit of using test support tools? Ensuring greater consistency and maintaining software project risk. So this is one thing that we want to achieve, the greater consistency. B, reducing repetitive work and gaining easy access to the test information. So both the answers are right as of now. Next, C, performing objective assessment and reducing the need for training. Okay, objective assessment is fine, we can do that using a tool, but reducing the need for training, this is not the case. For the tool we have to train people. D, allowing for greater reliance on the tool to automate the test process. So no, we are not allowing or forcing to use the tool always. Whenever it is required, that time only we should use the tool. So allowing the greater reliance on the tool is not a benefit, it is a risk actually, if you rely too much on the tool. So now if we see option A, minimizing the software project risk. Using a tool, we cannot minimize the project risk. Okay, this we are not doing. We are achieving the consistency, that's fine, but not reducing the risk. So whatever is the risk along associated with the project, that will be there. But if you see option B, it is completely right. Reducing repetitive work, yes, we use tool so that the repetitive works can be reduced, and gaining easy access to the test information. Since it is a tool, just by clicking or by selecting certain attributes, we can get the information. So option B is the answer over here.